After a frantic search, Mexican authorities say they have found the body of missing North Carolina teacher Patrick Braxton-Andrew and that he was killed by a member of a drug cartel. Braxton-Andrew was vacationing in Mexico. He was alone. He disappeared last month while walking near his resort in the northern Mexico town of Urique. Dianne Gallagher is our CNN national correspondent with more on this whole investigation and just how awful for this family. Tell us more about what he was doing down there and what authorities believe happened.
So, Brooke, this was something that he tended to do quite a bit. He would go to Mexico, he'd go to Latin America. He was a Spanish teacher and really loved the culture there. Now, the governor of Chihuahua claims that the Sinaloa cartel is responsible for his murder. Now, if that name sounds familiar to you, that's the cartel that El Chapo used to command before, of course, he was captured and is now on trial. But in a Facebook post from the governor, he pinned Braxton Andrews' killing on a drug trafficker known as El Chueco, or the Crooked. He says the middle school teacher died October 28th. That is the last day that he was seen by anyone. He left for a walk from his hotel to this canyon area. His body was found last week on a beach near that town of Urique, but beyond that, the death is kind of shrouded in mystery, Brooke. The governor's office says it appears the 34-year-old Spanish teacher's body had been buried and then exhumed and then just left out in the open. But he hasn't gone into detail as to how he was killed or even why he may have been targeted at this point. He called it a cowardly and brutal murder of a totally innocent person, but then he said it had nothing to do with an attempt to purchase drugs. Late last night, a Facebook page that's been run by his family and friends during this search confirmed, they said with a sense of relief, that his body was found and recovered. They're working on getting it back to North Carolina. Brooke, after learning of his death, they posted, Patrick died doing what he loved, traveling and meeting people. Join us in celebrating his life as he would want us all to do. We will always remember Patrick and his joy for life. Then later they added, although we are still grieving for Patrick, we have work to do and we're asking for your help. We continue to search for justice for Pat. A little bit later, Senator Tom Tillis, who actually lives near where Patrick taught Spanish at Woodlawn School, tweeted that he's working with the State Department and Mexican officials on the investigation. And Brooke, just like you said, you can imagine the past few weeks have been so difficult for his family and friends and really the whole community there north of Charlotte, not knowing what's going on, then getting this news and not having the answers. The school that he taught at canceled classes on Friday because of the news. And in Davidson, they lowered the flag to half staff to honor him in his memory. But really just so difficult for that community there.
I know people who knew the family. Same. And they had been looking for him. Yep. They had wanted help. And now to find out that he is gone like this is just, it's awful. Yeah. Dianne, thank you for the update and just thinking of this family back in North Carolina. Appreciate it.